हेलो एवरीवन, वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून. एम आई ऑडिबल टू ऑल ऑफ यू? प्लीज कमेंट यस. आई एम अवेटिंग फॉर योर रिस्पॉन्स. प्लीज राइट इन अ टेक्स्ट बॉक्स इफ I am audible to all of you with writing yes. We are starting with the session soon.
Yes, very good afternoon. I'm starting with the session, and let me remind you, if you found any trouble regarding the buffering of the website, then it is all the technical issues for which we are actually not responsible, and we are trying our best to give you the full through coverage via online. So on behalf of Priyadarshini Jain College of Pharmacy Nagpur, in collaboration with Quicklearn 360, a platform for the GPAT learners, we are organizing this online workshop on computer aided drug design. So I thanks all the department of Priyadarshini Jain College of Pharmacy faculties, all the delegates, and welcome you all on this online lecture, or we can say it is a workshop, because you will see the live session, how the docking can be done using AutoDock 4. So the topic of this online workshop is molecular docking using AutoDock 4. And this is for the beginners. So any student or faculty who is unaware about the docking and AutoDock 4, so this workshop will going to be a very useful tool. My name is Sapan Kesha, Assistant Professor, Priyadarshini Jail College of Pharmacy, Nagpur. To you all, before starting the hands-on AutoDock 4, let's learn what is docking. As a literature point of view, docking, particularly molecular docking, is a study of how two or more molecular structures, example drug and a receptor, match along to be a perfect fit. We can also say docking as predicting the best way the two molecules will interact. Let's have one example. This is a target molecule. The target, it can be a protein or it can be an enzyme, receptor, and the ligand molecule, which is a known chemical structure or newly synthesized chemical moiety. So we are going to predict how suitably this ligand molecule will fit into the crevices of this target molecule. This crevices is called as an active site of the target molecule. When the ligand fits into this crevices or active site of the target molecule, it forms a complex. And because of the binding of these two together, is maybe responsible for the generation of some effect. So binding of the target with the ligand, this terminology we can call it as a docking. Let us have an example, lock and key, which is a very familiar example. You know, we consider lock as a target molecule and key is a ligand. And we know there is a specific key which is available to get fit into the lock cavity devices. It's not possible that any key can bind with that lock and can generate a function. So there is a one selective specific key that should be available. However, when a thief comes in our home, sometimes, I pray God it do not happen to you. So when thief comes with the one artificial key which is not given by you, thief is able to open that lock. Why? Because the thief is also having a one key which is looking similar and to your original key and which can fit into the target molecule. So we are going to predict the different binding capacity of the ligand molecule with the target. So target can be a protein. I hope it is understood to you. So we say target can be a protein. It can be an enzyme. And ligand is a chemical structure. So the chemical structure, when fits with this target molecule, will measure the fitting of this chemical structure with the target molecule with the help of some software. And that softwares are known as a docking softwares. there is some issue I found with voice disturbances. So let me check my again connections. I am resolving this some connection issue if it is there. Okay, so what we are going to do today, we are going to use one docking software. And with the help of this docking software, we are going to analyze how better the ligand molecule will going to fit into the target structure. Okay, some are saying sound problem, some are saying no sound problem. So I am delivering now. If you have some problem, you know the session will going to be uploaded on the YouTube after the session gets over. So the person who is not able to hear it clearly can go through the session again and check whatever the missing words from him. So what I am saying, we are going to use a docking software. That is a free online available docking software, and we will see how to predict the score for the ligand molecule to get fit into this target structure. So for that, what we require, we have to obtain the 3D structure of the two molecule. We have to locate the base binding site. You know, the ligand molecule can fit only to this active site, it cannot fit anywhere else. And we are going to determine the base binding modes. Let us have the overall docking process with this single figure. Now see, this is a one structure, a chemical structure is available. This is an input compound from any databases. We'll see about databases later on. So we have this chemical entity, that is a chemical structure. And we have a known protein structure that is available, and we know that this chemical structure can bind with this receptor, and it is having a one particular docking score. Now we are going to generate the conformers of this chemical structure. We have a different conformations. Now we are going to predict how these conformers are having a probability, what the probability of this conformer is having to get bind with the target molecule. So we'll take one after one chemical structure. They are called conformers. We'll bind with this target molecule, target protein, and we estimate the docking score. After all conformers, when bind with the target protein, will have a list of the docking score for different chemical conformers. And out of them, the one conformer which binds very tightly, which binds perfectly the target molecule, will have a highest docking score. So this compound or this conformer which is having a best docking score will going to be our optimal structure, and that is selected for the further study. So hope this diagram is giving you explanation how the docking is going on. So we are starting the contents of the today's session. We'll first have how to download and install Autodoc, how to prepare a receptor file for the Autodoc, how to prepare a ligand file for the Autodoc, how to prepare a grid parameter file for the Autodoc, how to prepare a docking parameter file for the Autodoc, and how to run Dot2Doc and how to analyze the docking result. Dear friends, Autodoc is a freely available software. You can download it through this link. You can go through this link. Let us have one demonstration how we can go through this link and can download Autodoc for. Might be some of the students or teachers may have Autodoc on their computer, so they didn't need to download it, but the students who are new, who don't know, so they can go on this link. So see, the site is open, Autodoc. And when you go to this download link, you'll see Autodoc 4.2. To download this software, you have to first fill out this registration form and then to proceed to the download page. There is one more software, Autodoc Veena, is also available. You can download Autodoc Veena also. So when you click on this registration form, there is some information. This making of the softwares are asking from you. You very simply put on all this information, initial. Just name, email ID, institute name, department, and city, and then country. Submit it. So after the submission, you are able to download the Autodoc. As per your platform, if you are following Windows, you can download the Autodoc for the Windows. If you are using Linux, then you can go through this Linux link and so on. So I am having a window and I have already downloaded this Autodoc in my software, in my laptop. So I'll not go through that process, but a student who are new can go through this process and download the Autodoc for them. One more thing along with this Autodoc is required. It is a MGL tools. These are the supporting tools. So you can directly go to the download page on MGL tools. This software's MGL tools are required. It supports the Autodoc. If it is not available, then might be your Autodoc will not run properly. So you have to just download this MGL tool, set a file, and it is a very simple normal process. After downloading, there is a setup file is available and you have to execute that MGL tools. After executing MGL tools, you will find that the supporting documents which is required for the Autodoc will also get downloaded with this MGL tool. So after overall the process complete, the two softwares are being downloaded. One is Autodoc and second is the MGL tools. And you have to prepare one, folder, and this folder you have to keep all these files. The two are Autodoc Grid and Autodoc 4. And from MGL tools, you will get this 84 bound dot date and 84 parameters dot date. So these two files are also required, and that has to be kept in the same folder which you are going to use later on. Okay, and if are going through the Veena, so you have to use this Veena application and you have to download it. Okay, so keep all these files in a single folder only. So let us prepare one folder, and this folder preferably is to be prepared in a C drive. So I'm going in my C drive. Clicking on this new folder link. I have a new folder and I am naming it SKS. It is my abbreviations. So the folder is ready. Now when you open this folder, it is empty. So what you have to do, you take all these supporting files, 84.1, 84 parameter, Autodoc 4, Autogrid 4 and Veena. Now, maybe it is not required Autodoc Veena, this computer sign which is showing here. Okay, otherwise other softwares are required. See this? This one is not required. Okay, so I am making Control A, Control C, going to my folder which I have created just now, SKS, and making it copy paste. So now you can see in this SKS all these softwares are available at one place. Now closing it, going to my presentation and continue. Now see, step one is done. You have downloaded a new executable Autodoc. Now what is this Autodoc? As I said earlier, Autodoc is a suite of automated docking tools. And it is a freely available software, so anyone can use this Autodoc for the docking purposes. There are two generations of the software, Autodoc 4 and Autodoc Veena. Both are useful software. Nowadays, as compared to Autodoc 4, Autodoc Veena is more preferable. It is an advanced version. Just like our mobile, mein, you know, hota hai, there are so many versions are coming one after another. So similarly, after Autodoc 4, we are having Autodoc Veena. So this is an advanced version of the Autodoc. It runs fast. Now step 2. How to prepare the receptor file for the Autodoc 4. So to execute this step 2, we have to first of all open our Autodoc platform. So I am making it minimize. I am minimizing it. So simultaneously you will be able to see both this content. Now I am having a shortcut which is form in my desktop for the Autodoc. So I am opening this Autodoc tools. How many of you are doing lively and following me, or you are going to do it later on? I remind you that after the session over or in between somewhere, I am going to open the link for your attendance as well as the feedback form, and you will also able to obtain your certificate. So the students who are live are requested to stay connected till ends. There are some queries which I am getting. So when the registration form will be there, hai na? सो एक्चुअली जब पूरा सेशन हम कंप्लीट करेंगे तो उसके बाद ही हम रजिस्ट्रेशन लिंक ओपन कर रहे हैं, ठीक है। इन बिटवीन आपको अभी मिलेंगी या तो फिर सेशन के बाद में। सो अभी कोई क्वेरी उससे रिगार्डिंग नहीं होंगी तो ठीक है, अभी हम सेशन पे ध्यान देते हैं, राइट। सो नाउ व्हाट इज हैपन, मेरा देखिए यहाँ पे एक ऑटोडॉक का विंडो ओपन हो चुका है, ओके। इट इज जनरली कॉल्ड एज ए ग्राफिकल यूजर इंटरफेस। ऑटोडॉक को क्या बोला जाता है, इस विंडो को ग्राफिकल यूजर इंटरफेस। नाउ व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज ए ग्राफिकल यूजर इंटरफेस, बिकॉज दिस इज हेल्पफुल फॉर द स्टूडेंट और द पर्सन लाइक मी हु आर नॉट एबल टू यू नो यूज अ कमांड वेरी वेल। सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस ग्राफिकल इंफॉर्मेशन यू कैन व्यू द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अ लिगेंड, यू कैन व्यू द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अ प्रोटीन, एंजाइम, हेयर एंड एनीवन। सो आपको कोई कमांड या कोई लैंग्वेज के यू नो क्लासेस करने की गरज नहीं है, ओके। सो फर्स्ट स्टेप हमारा कंप्लीट हो चुका था, ऑटोडॉक फॉर डाउनलोडिंग इंस्टॉलिंग। नाउ वी हैव ओपन दिस ऑटोडॉक टूल्स, नाउ वी आर गोइंग फॉर द सेकेंड स्टेप, एंड द सेकेंड स्टेप इज how to prepare the receptor file. Now before my session, to session 1 was there, it is based on some protease inhibitor, right? So the one receptor which we have selected for today's second session, protease inhibitor, is 1-HPB. Now from where this 1-HPB is obtained and how I can download this 1-HPB and which format it is required. So you have to go to the Google. In the Google, you type this protein database. Please enter. So you obtain the home page of this protein data bank. What is this protein data bank? This is a website where all the protein data banks are stored. You know, we are conducting this online session because of the one problem, that is a corona. So in this platform, on this platform, you are also able to see the protein structure of this corona virus. Go to the basic search. So it's a network which is taking a time. Or if you know the name of that protein, you can directly add on Google the name of that protein and you will obtain this link for your protein structure. I have added 1-HPB. So 1-HPB is a protease enzyme. Here you can also place your search name, although I am not wasting much time. So you can see 1-HPB, it is a crystal structure of HIV-1 protease in complex with VX-478, a potent and orally bioavailable inhibitor of enzyme. Now you know viral protease inhibitor? What is viral protease inhibitor? So viral protease inhibitor, it prevents the viral replication by selectively binding with this enzyme. So any antiviral drug, ritonavir, okay, or remdesivir, which is in a clinical search of this novel coronaviral viral inhibition. So these are a category of drugs which binds with this protease, and they will going to prevent their replication. So what will happen? The replication of the viral RNA or DNA will not happen. And if the viral replication didn't happen, so virus will stop progressing further. I am having this 1HPV. It is a HIV-1 protease. And the structure of this HIV-1 protease is available in a complex with VX478. What is this VX478? When you scroll down, you can see this is a query on VX478. The 2D structure of this VX478 is available. Sometimes, in some cases, they also provide a 3D interaction structures. Although I have to go here, okay? So this is how your VX478 is looking. And this VX478 is bind with a B chain. There are two chains of this protease enzyme, A and B. And this VX478 is bound to the B chain of the viral protease enzyme. So you can just download the PDB file directly from this website. When you download, it will store at your download place. Or there is another way that is also available to get this PDB file. You can see the first is to download a protein data bank from this website, and second, you can fetch the protein data file directly. Now, how it is possible? Go to the file, go to the import, fetch from web, and here you write 1HPV. Okay. See what happened? Yes, the structure of this viral protease inhibitor. You can see the structure of this viral protease inhibitor. It is available in your Autodoc software. It is a protein structure made up of so many amino acids. You can see it is a linkage of various amino acids. Okay, and there is also VX478 is also available. I told you earlier, this viral protease is made up of two chains, chain A and chain B. So let us see how you can see this. You go to the select of this option, select from string. Now go to residue set. Chain list here. Now you can see what this structure is composed of. It's composed of 1HPV A chain, 1HPV B chain, DNA, and proteic compound. You can see from this website, VX478 is having a binding site at B chain. So we don't require A chain, okay? When I select this A chain, add, now you can see highlighted portion. What is this highlighted portion is? This highlighted portion is nothing but your A chain of this protease enzyme. Similarly, when you select chain B, you have to deselect chain A, add. Okay, both are selected. Okay, I am deselecting the complete molecule from here. Now, where is that VX478? Okay, select from string, go to the residue set. Here, go to the residue set, select ligand. And add. See what happened here. The yellow color mark is obtained, and what this yellow color structure is? So this is nothing but your VX478. How you can see this is a VX478? Now see from this website what the VX478 is composed of. It is having aniline ring at this one end, and tetrahydrofuranidine at another end. Okay, 5 member and this is a 6 member. Here also you can see it is a 5 member ring. Okay, and here at the end a 6 member ring is available. So this selected part is nothing but a structure of VX478. What is this VX478? It is a known molecule which has a binding capacity or which can act as an inhibitor for this HIV-1 protease enzyme. Okay, so step 2, we are proceeding further. As I said, I don't require this A chain, I am interested only for the B chain. So I will go to the select from string, remove this selection, go to the chain list, remove this part, select A chain, add, and I will delete this A chain. How to delete this? Go to the edit, delete, and in delete selected atoms, continue. Now see what happens. A chain is deleted. Ligand, do ligand molecule is also deleted? Let us check. Select from string. Now A chain is deleted. I am removing this selection, residue, go to the ligand, select. Okay, now see this ligand molecule still bind with your B chain. Okay, now what is the importance of this checking the site of binding? Because in the autodoc you have to fit the grid, and grid is selected from here. Go to the grid box. Okay, the grid box is selected. What is this grid box? This is a box where actually the autodock is going to perform your docking function, and you have to adjust the position of this grid box such a way that your binding area must be incorporated at the center of the grid box. This is a very important thing. So many, you know, videos available online which don't focuses on where actually the grid box has to be set. So you have to be very careful that the binding unit or binding site which you are targeting for your docking purpose should be placed at the center of this grid box. So this is how you can obtain a grid box. Again, go to the grid, select a grid box. Okay. Now see, the grid box is lying somewhere away from our position. So what we will do, we can move this grid box. How it is possible? One more thing, you can see the size of this grid box is 0.375. This is the default setting. I used to prefer some large grid box. So I am taking it 0.508 or 5. You should place as per your requirement. But in this case, I can see this binding site is perfect to fit into the size of this grid box. Sometimes the maximum size which can be possible for this grid box is 1, and when you don't know where actually your docking site is available, active binding site is available, in that case so many researchers used to take the full size grid box and used to, you know, place this molecule, target molecule, within that whole grid box. So हमें नहीं चाहिए इतना बड़ा ग्रिड बॉक्स, हमारे लिए आधा ग्रिड बॉक्स ही काफी है. तो हम क्या कर रहे हैं, हम से 0.506 ये साइज रख रहे हैं ग्रिड बॉक्स की अभी भी. लेकिन ग्रिड बॉक्स जो है इट इज लुकिंग अवे, सो आई एम एडजस्टिंग. नाउ हाउ टू मूव, सो दीज आर द स्पेसिंग्स अवेलेबल. नाउ आई हैव टू मूव टू द साइड ऑफ ग्रीन. सो व्हाट आई एम डूइंग, आई एम टेकिंग दिस वर्ड्स this side. Okay, so now box तो भी बहुत सेंटर में आ चुका है. ओके अभी मुझे इस साइड मूव करना है, सो मैं अभी ब्लू कलर की जो लाइनिंग से उसको सेट कर रहा हूँ. ठीक है अब देखिए मेरा ग्रिड बॉक्स एडजस्ट हो रहा है और वो मॉलिक्यूल को इनकॉर्पोरेट कर रहा है अपनी कैविटी के इनसाइड में. राइट अभी लग रहा है ये यहाँ पे सेट हो चुका है, तो मैं इसको मूव करके देख सकता हूँ ज़्यादा ही आ गया है ना. तो अभी इसको थोड़ा सा कम करेंगे. ये सब आपको ट्रायल एंड एरर बेसिस पे करते रहना है और जितना आपका हाथ बैठेगा उतने फास्ट आप ग्रिड बॉक्स को सेट कर सकते हैं. और तो वीना में ऐसा कहा जाता है यू डोंट रिक्वायर टू सेट अ ग्रिड बॉक्स. अभी मुझे रेड को फिट करना है. ओके सो नाउ यू कैन सी ये फिट हो गया. अब आपको दिख रहा है ये हमारा जो सिलेक्टेड लिगेंड मॉलिक्यूल है कि ग्रिड बॉक्स के इनसाइड में आ गया हूँ. ओ मैं कभी भी सेव नहीं किया था. ऑलवेज जब भी आप ग्रिड की सेटिंग कर लेते हैं उसके बाद आपको सेव करके रखना है. ओके यहाँ से फाइल क्लोज सेविंग करंट तो जो पोजीशन है वो सेव हो जाती है. अब हम जितने जल्दी इस ग्रिड बॉक्स को सेट करेंगे उतना हमारे लिए अच्छा रहेगा. तो आप समझ गए होंगे कि किस तरीके से ये सेट किया जाता है. ठीक है नाउ देखिए ब्लू से तो ऐसे दिख रहा है कि मॉलिक्यूल पूरा इनसाइड में. नाउ टॉप व्यू देखते हैं रेड का वो यहाँ पे नहीं है सो मुझे ब्लू को एडजस्ट करना है. ओके सो अभी रेड साइड से मुझे मॉलिक्यूल इनसाइड में दिख रहा है, ब्लू साइड से भी मॉलिक्यूल सेंटर में दिख रहा है, ग्रीन साइड बाकी है. लेट मी चेक. यस ग्रीन साइड से भी मॉलिक्यूल इनसाइड में आ चुका है. मैं क्लोज सेविंग करंट करता हूँ तो चेक कर दो थोड़ा सा कि और कुछ कर सकते हैं क्या. ग्रिड बॉक्स सी वही पोजीशन से आ गया. मैं इसको थोड़ा सा इस साइड ले आता हूँ. यस देखिए अब मॉलिक्यूल मेरा बिल्कुल सेंटर में राइट ना, ब्लू से भी सेंटर में दिख रहा है, नाउ रेड की कैविटी से भी सेंटर में दिख रहा है एंड फ्रॉम दिस ग्रीन कैविटी इट इज ऑल्सो लुकिंग सेंटर. सो द मॉलिक्यूल ग्रिड पॉइंट्स आर सेट कैन क्लोज सेविंग करंट. और वन मोर थिंग यू कैन डू हियर कैन सेव दिस पैरामीटर आउटपुट ग्रिड डायमेंशन. ओके अभी बोल रहा है हमने तो रिसेप्टर स्पेसिफाई नहीं किया तो अभी हमारा पहला स्टेप ही बाकी. व्हाट इज आवर फर्स्ट स्टेप लेट अस सी. फर्स्ट स्टेप इज डाउनलोड द प्रोटीन डाटा बैंक, फेच द प्रोटीन डाटा बैंक डायरेक्टली. तो अभी हमने प्रोटीन सेव कर लिया, प्रोटीन फेच कर लिया. वी हैव डिलीटेड द ए स्ट्रिंग. व्हाई? बिकॉज ए स्ट्रिंग इज डज नॉट हैविंग एनी रोल इन द डॉकिंग प्रोसेस विद दिस VX478. इवन वी डोंट रिक्वायर दिस VX478. तो व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल सिलेक्ट फ्रॉम स्ट्रिंग लिगेंड, add ligand, VX478 is now selected. Again go to the edit and delete selected atom. So what is happen, जो VX478 है अब वो भी delete हो गया. Okay अब सिर्फ आपका क्या बचा है, B chain बचा है your HIV1 protease enzyme का. Okay now what you have to do, you have to delete. Now these steps are very important to prepare your protein data bank. The first step is you have to go to the edit and delete water. So what will happen, all the water molecule which are present in this protein molecule will be deleted. Why it is necessary, it's very important because the water molecule may interfere with the ligand structure. So when your unknown ligand structure get fit into this protein molecule, might be the water molecule will interfere. And there is a no any software or available which measures the ligand efficiency in the presence of the water molecule. तो जितने भी हैं मोस्टली सब क्या करते हैं वाटर मॉलिक्यूल को पहले डिलीट करते हैं. आफ्टर डिलीटिंग द वाटर मॉलिक्यूल यू हैव टू गो टू द हाइड्रोजन ऐड हाइड्रोजन सिलेक्ट द पोलर ओनली व्हाट विल हैपन इट विल ऐड द चार्जेस टू द इंडिविजुअल अमाइनो एसिड इन द होल प्रोटीन मॉलिक्यूल. सो नाउ यू कैन से हाइड्रोजन आर बीइंग एडेड. नाउ ऐड चार्जेस ऐड कोलमेन चार्जेस. Again go to the edit, charges, compute charges. Now go to the edit, select the atom and assign AD4 type. Now your protein bank is ready. You can save in a PDBQT format. Now where you have to okay place. So सबसे पहले आपको place भी assign करना है. So what you do? Go to your folder where you want to actually save all this content. So I go into the C drive. In C drive, selecting this folder SKS where my all software is available. I am taking this path by using Control C. Okay. Going to this Autodoc file. Go to the preference set. And in set, it is a path which you have to specify. So I am specifying now the path is in a C drive SKS folder. So what will happen? Whatever be the task which I am doing here now in Autodoc 4 will be automatically save or assign to that particular position. So when I am saving now my ligand file in a PDBQT, see directly. It is saved at the C drive SKS folder in the name 1hpv.pdbqt. Select here sort nodes and make it OK. So what happened now in that C drive will have this file pdbqt. Although it is not a process file completely, it is half process. But the first step, second step, how to prepare the receptor file for the Autodoc is now done. So what we did, again revising, go to the Autodoc, go to the file, open target.pdb, target is specifying any the name of your protein. Here we are having a 1HPV, remove unwanted residue, we removed A residue, A chain, we remove the VX488, we deleted water molecule, we added a hydrogen, add a polar only, we added a charges, Coleman charges. Why? Because it adds the charges to individual amino acids. Then later on assign hydrogen AD4 type only and save your molecule as target.pdbqt. This step is over. Now going to the step 3. What is the step 3? How to prepare a ligand file for the Autodoc 4. Now what is a ligand? Ligand is any chemical structure and chemical structure that has to be saved in the two format only. Because your Autodoc can read only two types of the format. The first one is a PDB file and second one is a MOL2 file. These are the various online databases which is available from where you can obtain any structure in a PDB format or in a MOL2 format. When these structures are not available in PDB or MOL2 format, you can go to the various softwares like OpenBabel is available. You can use Avogadro only. This Avogadro will help you to save any structure into the MOL2 or PDB format. Okay, I use very oftenly. This is my favorite way to save any chemical structure into a MOL2 or PDB format. So, in the first session, sir has completed some virtual screening, and after the virtual screening, sir has given some structures. I am having that file now with me. after the session over, we'll have a doubt session of 10 to 15 minutes. The student who are having any doubt can ask doubts later on. Okay? So, sir ne ye file banaya tha aur sir ki reading se mujhe yahan pe ye pata chalta hai. This F15 is having highest docking score -7.9. So, what I am making now, I am making the MOL2 or PDB file for this structure. So, how it is possible? I am just double clicking on it. Because of this double click, it will open the CAM sketch. Okay. So, now this structure is open into CAM sketch. You can go to the tools, you can go to the generate and generate smile notation. So what will happen? Smile notations are being generated. You type Ctrl C. So your smile notations are being copied here. Now I am opening Avogadro. Go to the build, insert, smiles. Okay. Here you can paste. I have already pasted. I am making it okay. So your structure is being generated. Okay. Now file, save as. In which format you have to save? Either PDB or in a MOL2. And in which folder? What is your working folder? A working folder in this case is. In the C drive, it is SKS. I am naming it. What is the name of this? It is a F15. There are options. You can save it in MOL2. Even you can save it in PDB. Any format can be readable by Autodoc. So the file is now being saved in a MOL2 format. I am closing all this. I don't want any save. So two softwares are being closed, one Avogadro and second is CAM sketch. Now again going to this Autodoc session. Okay. Now go to the ligand. See here. Go to the ligand. In ligand input and open. Now what you have to open? You have to open your ligand file. Where this ligand file is available? In a C drive, SKS folder, right? Yes. Now it is not visible here, so go here and select all files. Yes, now F15 is visible, it is available in MOL2 format. So I am opening it. Yes. It is what it is showing, it's giving you a dialog box. It is saying, cap the charges from the MOL2 file, merge 9 known polar hydrogen, found 14 aromatic carbon, detected 1 rotatable bond. So your molecule which you have inserted is having a 1 rotatable bond. Okay. This is what your molecule. Now you can see this chemical structure is placed as far apart from your target because it is not docked here. So you have to first of all now save this ligand file into again PDB QT. So go to the output, same as PDB QT, your path is SKS and the file name is F15 and it is saved in a which format? PDB QT. Now I am saving. So what is happened? The second step is completed. What is the second step? Go to Autodoc. Go to ligand, input, open your file, ligand, output and save as a PDB QT. You can use any of these databases. If the time permits, we'll open each and every databases and I will explain you how you can obtain a chemical structure from these databases also. Okay. For now, we'll focus on the next step. So what is the next step? Here there are so many databases that are available. So next step is how to prepare a grid parameter file. Earlier you have set a grid box here. Okay. So you can see your grid box is already set. what we need to do, we have to go to the grid. Yes, it is visible. Go to the grid, select a macromolecule and choose a macromolecule. Now, which macromolecule you have to choose? 1HPV. Select, it will ask, write OK. It will open your folder SKS and ask to replace your 1HPV PDB QT file. So, make it yes and replace that 1HPV PDB QT file. So, what happens? Your PDB QT, your receptor file now is available in grid parameter file. Now, again go to the grid, save output, save as GPF, and give the file name as 1HPV dot GPF. Save. Okay. Now, step 4 is grid optimization, so it is over. So, what we did? We have selected a grid macromolecule, choose a target, save as target.pdbqt. We are using 1HPV, so we saved 1HPV.pdbqt. Then we selected a grid box. Earlier we did it, we saved the grid parameter. Then later on we went to this grid output and save our 1HPV.gpf. Okay, so step 4 is over. Now what is the step 5? Step 5 is running a auto grid. So go to the run. Yes, go to the run. Select run auto grid. Okay, before doing that, step 5 here mentioned here, but what we are doing? Okay, let me go to this step 5. Go to the docking, select a macromolecule, select a rigid file name. Your rigid file name is 1HPV. Now, why to select this rigid file name? You know, because your protein is actually set as rigid. However, in some cases, if you have a certain kind of residue in your protein structure which have a changeable conformation, so in that case you will going to select a flexible residue file. However, in our case we don't have such a type of system, so we are selecting only a set rigid file. Okay, got it. So we have selected rigid file name. Which was our select rigid file name? It is a 1HPV. Now go to docking, select a ligand, choose which one our ligand is, F15. So I will select F15 ligand. Now accept. Again go to the docking, select output, use Lamarckian algorithm. This is a very well, you know, research algorithm and it gives accurate data. So all nowadays are using this algorithm only. So save your file 1HPV dot in DPF format. Okay, so it is saved in 1HPV DPF. Now the two things, so now it is open. Step 5 is done. So we have go to the docking macromolecule, select the rigid file name. Second is going docking ligand, choose the ligand, then you can set these parameters if you want, or directly go to the docking output Lamarckian and save as target dot in a DPF format. Step 5 is completed. Now the next step. And next step is how to run AutoDock. Now when you see this running of this AutoDock, yes, there are two ways. One is to run an AutoDock. And before running AutoDock, you have to run AutoGrid. Or the second system is to run AutoDock Vina. What I have seen, to run this AutoDock Vina, it requires a very less time. However, to run AutoGrid, it requires a lot of time. So, I am giving a first demonstration for this AutoDock Vina. AutoGrid an auto dog will take near about half hour other. So I'm taking this run Autodog Veena, and how you can go run this Autodog Veena. So I have given the command here. First of all, you have to go to your folder, okay, and before that you have to open a command prompt. So I'm opening command prompt, okay. So command prompt is open. Just taking 2 minutes. ओके तो अभी हमें क्या करना है, वी हैव टू रन द ऑटोडॉग वीना. तो उसके लिए हमने क्या ओपन किया है, हमने ओपन किया है कमांड प्रॉम्प्ट. नाउ जब हम कमांड प्रॉम्प्ट देख रहे हैं तो ये कौन सी पोजीशन पे लोकेटेड है, ये कोई दूसरी पोजीशन पे लोकेटेड है. तो सबसे पहले व्हाट आई हैव टू डू, मुझे इसका पाथ असाइन करना है. इसलिए बहुत ही सिंपल सा कमांड है. आपको टाइप करना है D space then C column slash it is a forward slash, और आपको उस फोल्डर का नाम लिखना है जहां पे आपका सारा सॉफ्टवेयर का डाटा स्टोर है, जहां पे आपको रन करना है. ओके, आई एम टाइपिंग SKS, नाउ टाइपिंग एंटर. सो अब इसने मुझे यहाँ पे पाथ सिलेक्ट करके रख लिया. कौन सा पाथ है, इट इज SKS फोल्डर. नाउ What is the next step? Next step है Autodog Veena का command. उसके लिए एक और चीज करनी बहुत जरूरी है. आपको एक फाइल सेव करनी है. It is called as a conf file. मैंने कुछ प्रोसेस करके रखा है तो मैं पहले से ही उस फाइल को यूज किया है. इस कन्फ फाइल को आपको सेव करना है फिर से वही जगह पे, सी ड्राइव SKS. कौन सी फाइल है, कॉन्फ, CONF. ये सिंपल टेक्स्ट फाइल है. कैसे लुक है टेक्स्ट फाइल का, व्हाट इट इज शोइंग, तो आपको कुछ ऐसा डाटा टेक्स्ट फाइल में स्टोर करके रखना है. नाउ व्हाट इट इज, यू हैव टू टाइप रिसेप्टर इक्वल टू, रिसेप्टर का नाम क्या है हमारा, 1HP. लिगेंड, लिगेंड का नाम क्या है, F15. उसके बाद सेंटर, अभी हमारे ग्रिड डायमेंशंस दिख रहे हैं हमें. तो फिर से जाएंगे हम ऑटोडॉग पे, सिलेक्ट करेंगे ग्रिड बॉक्स, और ये यहाँ पे एक्सटेंडर कितना है, 7.981. ओके, सो मुझे यहाँ पे एक्सटेंडर टाइप करना है 7.98 1, then center y, उसके dimension 14.897, उसके बाद z के dimension 9.129. okay, बाकी यहाँ पे देखिए ये कितने grid के parameters है, 40 40 40, so it is 40 40 40, and you have to set exhaustiveness is equal to 8. ये file की जो link है मैं आपको end में इस YouTube channel पे upload कर दूँगा, तो आप डायरेक्टली फाइल को एडिट कर सकते हैं इसी तरह. ओके, बाकी तो हमारे ग्रिड पैरामीटर सेव है, इसको भी हम सेव कर लेते हैं, सेव चेंजेस। तो सेव हो गए हमारे चेंजेस, यस। तो अभी हमारी कॉन फाइल भी रेडी हो गई है। और एक कमांड जो बहुत ज्यादा यूज में आता है यहाँ पे, कमांड टू रन अबीना। व्हाट इज दिस? सी ड्राइव प्रोग्राम फाइल इन दैट द स्क्रिप्ट रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट बीना बीना डॉट exe डबल स्पेस डैश डैश रिसेप्टर। अभी हमारा रिसेप्टर कौन सा है यहाँ पे, 1HPV.PDBQT डबल स्पेस डबल डैश लिगेंड। अभी लिगेंड कौन सा है, F15। फिर डबल स्पेस डबल डैश कन्फिग स्पेस conf डॉट टीएक्सटी स्पेस डैश डैश लॉग स्पेस लॉग डॉट टीएक्सटी स्पेस स्पेस डैश डैश आउट आउट डॉट pdbqt। इस कमांड को डायरेक्टली कॉपी करिए और कमांड प्रॉम्प्ट में कंट्रोल वी करके इसे रन करिए। सो नाउ व्हाट इज हैपनिंग, यू कैन सी कंप्यूटर इज एनालाइजिंग योर ऑटोडॉक बीना स्कोप एंड इट इज रनिंग। यू कैन सी द प्रोसेस ऑफ योर बीना हाउ इट इज रनिंग। मैंने कहा जैसे ऑटोडॉक बीना इट टेक्स अ वेरी लेस टाइम, तो ये एग्जीक्यूट हो रहा है एंड इट इज कंप्लीटिंग सून। यस, द डाटा इज कंप्लीटेड। नाउ दिस फाइल इज जनरेटेड, द फर्स्ट आउट सेकंड कॉलम। ओके, सो जो नेटवर्क इश्यू था उसको हमने रिजॉल्व किया है और अब हम फिर से हमारे लाइव स्ट्रीमिंग पे वापस आते हैं। सो हम कहां रुके थे, हमने कमांड प्रॉम्प्ट रन किया था। ओके, सब लोगों ने देख लिया कमांड प्रॉम्प्ट कैसे रन होता है। उसके बाद क्या हुआ, कमांड प्रॉम्प्ट रन होने के बाद हमें रिजल्ट दिखाई दिया, कौन सी जगह पे, हमारे फोल्डर में। व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ आवर फोल्डर, SKS, एंड द रिजल्ट्स आर सेव्ड इन टू फाइल। फर्स्ट इज अ लॉग फाइल, यू कैन सी द लॉग फाइल। ओके, रिजल्ट्स आर गिवन, द फर्स्ट वन विच इज हैविंग अ जीरो RMSD वैल्यू, लोएस्ट RMSD वैल्यू, is having a docking binding score -6.5, and it is said that jitna docking score minus mein jyada se jyada rahega itna jyada fitting best fit hota hai aapka molecule, so inhibition probability badh jati hai, and not saying inhibition karega but the probability will going to be increased, and the output file, the output file, you can see this output file, what is happening, what is given, they are given in a form of a numerical values, and as it is, मैंने कहा the students or the teachers were not prompt with the commands and all, so उनके लिए output file इस तरीके से read करना possible नहीं है, so we will see later on how you can check the results from this output file. Now before proceeding that, we should run the auto doc also, okay? And auto doc run करने के लिए जो कमांड से वो यहाँ पे अवेलेबल है। ओके, ये फाइल का एक्सेस भी मैं आपको दे दूंगा मेरी PPT का, तो जो लोग घर से करना चाहते हैं बाद में आफ्टर द सेशन गेट्स ओवर, तो दे कैन यूज दिस PPT फाइल। ओके, तो इसकी भी लिंक मैं आपको दे दूंगा। सो अब हमें ऑटोडॉक रन करना है, तो हाउ टू रन दिस ऑटोडॉक, गो टू द रन, सिलेक्ट ऑटो ग्रिड, रन ऑटो ग्रिड, गो टू द ब्राउज। यहाँ पे आपको सिलेक्ट करना है फिर से ऑटो ग्रिड एप्लीकेशन, क्योंकि आपको ऑटो ग्रिड पहले सिलेक्ट करना है। देखिए बीना में हमने कोई ग्रिड पैरामीटर सेट नहीं किया ना, तो भी चलता है, बिकॉज बीना इज हैविंग अ प्रोसीजर, इट इंटीग्रेट इटसेल्फ वेरियस ग्रिड पैरामीटर। हाउएवर ऑटोडॉक कैन नॉट ग्रिड ऑल द पैरामीटर्स, इसलिए हम पहले ऑटो ग्रिड एग्जीक्यूट करेंगे। सो हमने GPF फाइल बनाई थी, उसे ओपन करेंगे एंड विल लॉन्च इट। सो यू कैन सी दिस इज अ टास्क बार, दिस इज शोइंग द ग्रिड फाइल इज एग्जीक्यूटिंग। ओके, जैसे बॉक्स गायब हो गया मींस ग्रेट एग्जीक्यूट हो चुका है. लेट सी द ग्रेट रिजल्ट्स. नाउ ग्रेट रिजल्ट्स में क्या होगा, आपकी जो जीपीए फाइल है इट विल बी कन्वर्टेड टू जीएलजी फाइल. सो यू कैन सी देयर इज वन जीएलजी फाइल इज अवेलेबल, वन एचपीवी, और ये उसके डाटा सेट है. अभी हमें समझने में